Welcome to my video tutorial on gross anatomy of suprarenal glands. By the end of this video, you should be able to know the general features of suprarenal glands like their location, measurements and capsules, presenting parts and their relations, macroscopic structure of the glands, arterial supply, venous drainage, lymphatic drainage, nerve supply of the glands and few clinical aspects. So let's begin. Suprarenal glands or adrenal glands. They are one of the endocrine glands of human body. They are a pair of golden yellow flattened bodies situated over the upper end of corresponding kidney. Here are the suprarenal glands. They are retroperitoneal structures seen on the posterior abdominal wall, resting on posterior fibers of diaphragm. Let's see the location of suprarenal glands. They lie against T12 and L1 vertebrae. Here the image is showing fetal abdominal cavity with developing lobulated kidneys and developing suprarenal glands here. The fetal glands form 1/3 of the corresponding kidney, whereas the adult glands form only 1/13th of the corresponding kidney because of their regression and rapid growth of the kidney. Here are the adult kidneys and here are the adult suprarenal glands. Each gland measures about 5 cm in height, 3 cm in breadth and 1 cm in thickness. Each gland weighs around 5 grams. Each suprarenal gland is enclosed by two capsules. They are inner true capsule and outer false capsule. Inner true capsule is formed by condensation of fibrous stroma, whereas outer false capsule is formed by renal fascia. Renal fascia is one of the coverings of kidney. It has two layers, anterior layer and posterior layer. Both the layers unite at the upper end of the kidney. From there, they resplit to enclose the suprarenal gland. Above the gland, two layers reunite and continue as suspensory ligament of suprarenal gland, which gets attached to the undersurface of corresponding dome of the diaphragm. Because of this ligament, suprarenal gland and kidney move with the respiration along with the movements of diaphragm. Let's move on to presenting parts and relations of suprarenal glands. We will begin with the right suprarenal gland, its parts and relations. It is triangular shaped or pyramidal shaped gland which has a base, apex, two surfaces, anterior surface and posterior surface, two borders, lateral border and medial border. Let's see the features of presenting parts of right suprarenal gland. Here is the right suprarenal gland. Its base lies below and overlaps the upper end of right kidney. Apex lies above. It shows hilum. Hilum of the suprarenal gland defined as where the suprarenal vein leaves the parenchyma. That portion of the gland is known as hilum. Hilum of right suprarenal gland is situated near the apex onto the anterior surface of the gland. Apex of the gland in anatomical position overlapped by inferior vena cava, which means the gland lies behind the inferior vena cava. Coming to the anterior surface of the gland is divided by a vertical ridge into medial area and lateral area. Medial area is completely overlapped by inferior vena cava, which means it is non-peritoneal. Lateral area, here it is. It is related with above bare area of the liver. Here, which means it is non-peritoneal. Lower part is related with superior duodenal flexure. Flexure between first and second parts of duodenum. This area is covered by peritoneal layer. The upper and lower parts of lateral area are separated by a peritoneal reflection, which forms the inferior layer of coronary ligament. It is one of the ligaments covering the bare area of the liver. So the anterior surface is divided into two areas, medial and lateral. Medial area is non-peritoneal, overlapped by inferior vena cava, whereas lateral area related with above bare area of the liver, below superior duodenal flexure. Above it is non-peritoneal, below it is peritoneal. Both the parts are separated by inferior layer of coronary ligament. Posterior surface of the gland. Here it is. The posterior surface of right suprarenal gland is divided into two areas, upper area and lower area, depending on the visceral relations. The upper area rests on the posterior sloping fibers of diaphragm. And outside to the diaphragmatic fibers, posterior surface related with costo-diaphragmatic recess of corresponding pleural sac. The lower area encroaches onto the medial border and anterior surface of right kidney. So the posterior surface, depending on the visceral relations, divided into two areas, upper and lower. Upper area related with diaphragm and costo-diaphragmatic recess of corresponding pleural sac. The lower area encroaches onto medial border and anterior surface of the right kidney. Lateral border of the gland. Here it is. It is related with inferior surface of the liver, where it forms the suprarenal impression. Medial border. Here it is. It is related with right crest of the diaphragm and right cilia ganglion and right inferior phrenic artery. So the lateral border is overlapped by the liver, whereas medial border is related with right crest and the structures related to it, right cilia ganglion and right inferior phrenic artery. Let's quickly revise the presenting parts and relations of right suprarenal gland. Here is the anterior view of the gland and here is the posterior view. It's a triangular shaped gland having an apex above, base below. Two surfaces, anterior surface and posterior surface. Two borders, medial border and lateral border. Apex is related with inferior vena cava and it shows a hilum near the anterior surface. Base overlaps the upper end of right kidney. Anterior surface is divided by a vertical ridge into medial area and lateral area. Medial area related with inferior vena cava, whereas lateral area in its upper part related with liver, lower part related with superior duodenal flexure. Posterior surface is divided into upper and lower areas. Upper area related with diaphragm and costo-diaphragmatic recess. Lower area is related with medial border and anterior surface of the right kidney. Medial border of the gland related with right crest of the diaphragm, right cilia ganglion and right inferior phrenic artery. Lateral border is related with inferior surface of the liver, where it forms the suprarenal impression. Let's move on to presenting parts and relations of left suprarenal gland. Here it is. It is longer and lies at a higher level than the right suprarenal gland. It also lies nearer to vertebral column. It's a semilunar shaped gland having following features. Two ends, lower and upper ends, two surfaces, anterior and posterior. two borders, lateral and medial borders. Let's see the further features of these presenting parts. Here is the left suprarenal gland. Here is the lower end and here is the upper end. Lower end shows hilum of the gland, where the left suprarenal vein leaves the parenchyma. The lower end encroaches onto medial border of the left kidney. Upper end, it is closely related with visceral surface of the spleen, where it forms suprarenal impression. So the lower end shows hilum related with the medial border of the left kidney. Upper end is related with spleen. Coming to the anterior surface, here is the left suprarenal gland with its anterior surface. In its upper part, it is covered by parietal layer of peritoneum. In its lower part, it is non-peritoneal. Depending on the peritoneal relations, the anterior surface is divided into two areas, upper area and lower area. Upper area is covered by peritoneum of lesser sac, which means it is related with posterior surface of the body of the stomach near to its cardiac end. Lower area, which is overlapped by body of the pancreas, which means lower area is non-peritoneal. So the anterior surface of left suprarenal gland is divided into two areas, upper and lower. Upper area related with peritoneal layer of lesser sac, posterior surface of the body of the stomach. Lower area related with body of the pancreas. It is non-peritoneal. Posterior surface, here it is. Posterior surface of left suprarenal gland can be divided into two areas, medial area and lateral area, depending on its visceral relations. The medial area, here it is. It rests on left crest of the diaphragm. As the left suprarenal gland lies nearer to the vertebral column. Lateral area, it encroaches onto medial border and anterior surface of the left kidney. So the posterior surface of left suprarenal gland can be divided into medial and lateral areas. Medial area rests on left crest of the diaphragm. Lateral area related with medial border and anterior surface of left kidney. Coming to the borders of the gland. Lateral border, it is concave and overlaps the anterior surface of left kidney. Medial border, it is convex, related with left celiac ganglion, left inferior phrenic artery and a branch from celiac trunk, left gastric artery. So the borders of left suprarenal gland are lateral border and medial border. Lateral border is concave, related with anterior surface of left kidney. Medial border is convex, related with left celiac ganglion, left inferior phrenic artery, and a branch from celiac trunk, left gastric artery. Let's quickly revise the presenting parts and relations of left suprarenal gland. Here is the left suprarenal gland with its anterior view and posterior view. It's a semilunar shaped gland having two ends, lower end, upper end, two surfaces, anterior and posterior, two borders, medial border and lateral border. Lower end is related with anterior surface of left kidney and it shows hilum of the gland. Upper end is related with spleen. Anterior surface is divided into two areas, upper and lower. Upper area is related with posterior surface of body of the stomach and it is covered by peritoneum of lesser sac. Lower area is related with body of pancreas. Posterior surface is divided into medial and lateral areas. Medial area is related with left crest of diaphragm. Lateral area is related with anterior surface of left kidney. Medial border is convex, related with left celiac ganglion, left inferior phrenic artery and left gastric artery. Lateral border is concave, and overlaps the anterior surface of left kidney. Now it's worthwhile here to know the structures lying between medial borders of right and left suprarenal glands. They are from right side to left side, right crest of the diaphragm, right ciliar ganglion and right inferior phrenic artery. In the midline, structures passing through the aortic opening of diaphragm, lumbar azygous vein, occasionally cisterna chyli and abdominal aorta with the origin of celiac trunk. Left to the aortic opening, left ciliar ganglion, left inferior phrenic artery and a branch from celiac trunk, left gastric artery, which are resting on left crest of the diaphragm. So these are the major relations lying between the medial borders of right and left suprarenal glands across the midline from right side to left side. So that is about the presenting parts and relations of right and left suprarenal glands. The points to be understood here are: right suprarenal gland is pyramidal or triangular in shape, whereas left suprarenal gland is semilunar in shape. Their surfaces are divided into few areas depending on their visceral and peritoneal relations. The right suprarenal gland shows its hilum near to its apex, whereas left suprarenal gland shows its hilum near its lower end. Coming to the macroscopic structure of the suprarenal glands. Here is the cross section of the gland showing outer cortex and inner medulla. So each gland consists of outer cortex and inner medulla. The medulla forms only 1/10 of the entire gland. Histologically, the cortex divided into three zones from outside to inside. They are zona glomerulosa, cells of which secrete mineralocorticoids. Deep to that, zona fasciculata, cells of which secrete glucocorticoids. The deepest layer of the cortex, zona reticularis, cells of which secrete sex hormones, androgens or estrogen. Medulla is composed of long columnar cells, sinusoids and capillaries. The columnar cells of the medulla, they give brown color when they are stained with potassium bichromate. Such reaction is known as chromaffin reaction, which is why the cells of medulla are known as chromaffin cells. Functionally, the cells of cortex, as they secrete hormones, the cortex belongs to endocrine system, whereas the cells of medulla, they belong to sympathetic system, as they act as postganglionic sympathetic neurons. Now it's time to see the arterial supply of suprarenal glands. Each gland is supplied by three sets of arteries. They are superior suprarenal arteries, middle suprarenal artery and inferior suprarenal artery. The superior suprarenal arteries are multiple in number. They are branches of inferior phrenic artery, which in turn is a branch of abdominal aorta. Middle suprarenal artery is a direct branch from abdominal aorta, whereas the inferior suprarenal artery is a branch of renal artery. So the three sets of arteries which supply the suprarenal glands are superior, middle and inferior suprarenal arteries. The branches arising from suprarenal arteries, they pierce the capsules of the gland and form subcapsular arterial plexus. Such subcapsular arterial plexus give rise to arteries which communicate the sinusoids of cortex and sinusoids of medulla. The communicating arteries between cortical and medullary sinusoids are known as suprarenal portal system. Let's see the venous drainage of suprarenal glands. Each gland is drained by a single suprarenal vein. The right suprarenal vein comes out of the gland through the hilum near the apex of the gland, whereas left suprarenal vein comes out of the gland through the hilum at the lower end of the gland. Once the right suprarenal vein comes out of the gland, it directly opens into inferior vena cava, whereas the left suprarenal vein communicates with or receives left inferior phrenic vein and opens into left renal vein, which in turn opens into inferior vena cava. So the right suprarenal vein drains into inferior vena cava directly, whereas left suprarenal vein drains into left renal vein. So that is about the arterial supply and venous drainage of suprarenal glands. The points to be remembered here are, there are three sets of arteries supplying each suprarenal gland. They are superior, middle and inferior suprarenal arteries. But there is only one suprarenal vein draining each gland. The right suprarenal vein drains into inferior vena cava directly, whereas left suprarenal vein opens into left renal vein. Coming to the lymphatic drainage of suprarenal glands. Lymph channels from each gland drain into lateral aortic or para-aortic group of lymph nodes, along with the lymphatics from kidney. Now supply of suprarenal glands. The cortex of the gland belongs to endocrine system, and the secretions of cortical cells are controlled by anterior pituitary through ACTH, adrenocorticotrophic hormones. Whereas the medulla, which belongs to sympathetic system, it secretes catecholamines like epinephrine and norepinephrine. The secretions of medullary cells are controlled by sympathetic fibers from T8 to L1 spinal cord segments. So the preganglionic sympathetic fibers, which are derived from T8 to L1 spinal cord segments, they pass through the celiac plexus, which is seen around the celiac trunk near the celiac ganglia. From there, the fibers reach the medulla and relay at chromaffin cells, which act as postganglionic neurons, which means the target cells are itself acting as postganglionic neurons, which is why the medulla of adrenal gland is known as terminal sympathetic ganglion. Now it's time to see the clinical aspects. Addison's disease, in which there is deficiency of mineralocorticoids. It may be due to autoimmune or tuberculous destruction of both the glands. It presents with hypotension, muscle weakness, and weight loss. Cone syndrome. It's an adrenal hyperplasia in which there is excessive mineralocorticoid secretion, which presents with hypertension. Cushing syndrome. It is also an adrenal hyperplasia due to pituitary adenoma, which results in excessive production of ACTH, further leading to excessive secretion of glucocorticoids. It is manifested by truncal obesity, hypertension, moon-like face, thin limbs, poor wound healing. In females, it causes hirsutism. Developing male secondary sexual characteristic features. Adrenogenital syndrome, in which there is excessive secretion of adrenal androgens from zona reticularis. It results in masculinization of females, developing male secondary sexual characteristic features, and precocious puberty, or early puberty in males. Pheochromocytoma, a medullary tumor due to which there is excessive secretion of catecholamines, which causes hypertension. Accessory suprarenal tissue, which may found around the main glands or within the root of or two layers of mesentery or within the broad ligament of uterus in females or within the spermatic cord or near the testis in males. Here is the end of this video with all the objectives concerned with suprarenal glands or adrenal glands. Thank you for your patient listening. Keep learning.